scored three in the win. Oh, it's good!
2020 NBA championship belongs to the Los Angeles Lakers.
Hello, Lakers Nation. Welcome in. Trevor Lane here for LakersNation.com, your home for everything Lakers. Talen Horton-Tucker, piece for the Lakers' future or trade chip this summer. I'm going to break it down. First, quick reminder, this is going to be one of the most important off seasons in Lakers history. Make sure you are subscribing right here to the Lakers Nation YouTube channel for our full breakdown of everything going on in the world of the Los Angeles Lakers. Turn on those notifications as well so you get notified every time we put out a new video. All right, so Talen Horton-Tucker certainly did not have the season that we hoped he would this year. We saw THT get paid last offseason, got a three-year deal from the Lakers, made him the fourth highest paid player on the team. Of course, you had the three max players, LeBron, Anthony Davis, and Russell Westbrook. And then after that, you had Talen Horton-Tucker, just over $9 million. Again, the fourth highest paid player. He was expected to take a leap this season. His year 21 or age 21 season was expected to step up. In fact, I think the Lakers went a little bit too far hyping up Talen Horton-Tucker in the offseason. You had both Frank Vogel and Rob Pelinka talk about Talen Horton-Tucker becoming the team's defensive stopper on the perimeter. Now, physically, his physical profile suggests that maybe at some point that's what he could be. 6'4 with a 7'1 wingspan. We've seen what a difference wingspan can make in the NBA. But again, we haven't seen the defensive chops from him yet to actually fulfill that potential that he's got. So to put that on a 21-year-old to say he is going to replace guys like Alex Caruso and Kentavious Caldwell-Pope as being the team's defensive stopper on the perimeter, that's probably asking him to do a bit too much. And of course, we saw defensively how things went for the Lakers this season. It was not pretty. But regardless, the Lakers and Lakers Nation was expecting more out of Talen Horton-Tucker this season. You take a peek at his stats and, well, it's certainly disappointing. Typically, you would think young players, as they progress through their careers, they would get better. But with Talen Horton-Tucker, statistically, yeah, he got a bit worse. Actually had the worst three-point percentage of his career, just 27% from three, 28% from three the season before. Averaged 10 points per game in 25 minutes, 3.2 rebounds, 2.7 assists to go along with 1.4 turnovers per game, and only shot 42% from the field, and I'm rounding up to get there, 41.6%. from the field for THT. Now, he did shoot 80% from the free throw line. Typically, free throw shooting is a good indicator of the overall shooting ability of a player. So why can we be optimistic about Talen Horton-Tucker's shot moving forward? Because let's face it, when we look at THT's game, he already has the ability to finish at the basket. He's got the scoops from the funky angles. He can handle the basketball a little bit. He can pass the ball a little bit. The problem is, teams don't defend him behind the three-point line. So how do you fix his offensive game? So much of it is going to be dependent upon him getting that jump shot rolling. Now, we can also mention that he suffered a ligament tear in the thumb of his shooting hand, his right hand, in preseason. How much did that set back the shooting progress that he made last summer? Is that the real culprit when we look at his shooting numbers this season? I don't think we can put it completely on that. But I also don't think it's fair if we don't mention the fact that he suffered an injury to his shooting hand right before the season started, missed a decent chunk of the season as a result as well, and then had to try to get back and get back up to speed as quickly as possible. But once again, how we view Talen Horton-Tucker moving forward, particularly on the offensive end, a lot of it, not all of it, but a lot of it is going to be dependent upon the development of his jumper. Defensively, again, has a great physical profile defensively, but can he get the defensive instincts that he needs in order to be successful at the NBA level? That is still up in the air and a question mark. And again, for a guy who's the fourth highest paid player on your team, you don't really want that many question marks. So what does the future hold for Talen Horton-Tucker? It seems like a no-brainer that he's going to be on the trade market, if for no other reason than the Lakers need to make changes. They've got to try to fix this. And Talen Horton-Tucker's contract is probably one of the only things that they have available that they can trade in terms of just matching salaries. I'm talking about just logistics, trying to get a deal done via trade. We've talked a lot about Russell Westbrook trades. We saw this at the trade deadline as well, where in order to make a move, you almost have to include Talen Horton-Tucker's salary. He'll be at just over $10 million next year, and then has a player option for about $11 million and change the following season. And that is really important. I actually think that if the Lakers decide to trade Talen Horton-Tucker this summer, they will be trading him at a low point. Now, I'm not saying that means it's the wrong decision to make, but I do think from a value perspective, you're probably going to get less for him this summer than you would at any other point of his career. And the reason for that is because he's coming off of, number one, coming off of a bad season for him. Now, again, he showed flashes of potential, dropped 40 points in a game at the end of the season there. So we've seen that he is still talented, but the consistency hasn't been there for him. And the big question marks, everybody around the league knew this. Could he get the shot going? Well, he turned in his worst three-point percentage of his career, injury or otherwise. That's the bottom line. That's what it was. It was the worst three-point percentage season of his young career. So that is still a huge question mark. And then contractually, here's the problem for opposing teams. If you're another team and you trade for Talen Horton-Tucker and he plays well, let's say the shot comes around. Next thing you know, he's a league average three-point shooter. Hey, it's a big leap, I know. But let's just say the stars align and THT is a league average three-point shooter. He's hitting about 35% plus from three next season, and teams now have to defend him behind the arc. That opens up the driving game for him. He becomes a little bit more responsible as decision maker. Everything clicks. Great. You're super happy that you traded for him, right? Maybe. The problem is he's got a player option. If all of that happens and suddenly he's the player that the Lakers hoped he would be and you just traded for him and you bought low on THT, you're an opposing team. You now know that he's going to probably opt out of that player option, that $11 million, and he's going to look to get paid, which means you're either going to lose him and get no return in free agency, or he's going to sign with you and you're going to have to pay him a lot more. Now, maybe if he plays well enough, that doesn't bother you all that much. But again, from a value perspective, that's not exactly the situation you want to be in if you're an opposing team trading for Talen Horton-Tucker. Again, had a bad season, and then contractually, there's reason why teams would not want to deal with that situation. And look, the flip side is also true. Let's say he turns in another season next year, the same as this one, where his shooting is abysmal, teams don't defend him behind the arc, his defense is spotty, it doesn't really work out for him. Well, then you're in a situation where he picks up that player option, and you just overpaid him for 1 year, because let's face it, THT, based on current production, is not worth $10 million per season. So if you overpay him for this year, then you're going to have to overpay him once again for another season if things don't click for him. Now, again, that's not necessarily what I'm projecting for THT, but you can see why if you're an opposing team trading for Talen Horton-Tucker, you wouldn't be super excited about forking over top dollar in terms of trade assets for him. Now, that said, like I mentioned, trading Talen Horton-Tucker isn't necessarily the wrong decision for the Lakers, even if you agree with me and say, yeah, this is probably a low point for him in terms of value. If what you're getting in return, your opportunity cost, is correct, then it might still be worth it to trade him. If you find a deal out there that you think really works and is going to help you potentially fix this and contend for a championship next season, well, then you're probably okay with parting with the future of Talen Horton-Tucker. For example, I don't think the Lakers are regretting trading for Anthony Davis. We're seeing Brandon Ingram do some amazing things in the playoffs. No question. Look, Josh Hart turned into a very, very solid player himself. Lonzo Ball has flashed things. Of course, we're looking at the draft picks, all the stuff that they gave out in the Anthony Davis trade. But ultimately, the Lakers won a championship. And so I don't think they're regretting that trade at all. I think we could be in a similar situation, albeit to a much lesser degree, with Talen Horton-Tucker, where if you get the pieces back that fix the evils of last season, and then they turn this team back into a contender, I don't think you're going to be losing sleep if a few years down the road, Talen Horton-Tucker is suddenly a pretty solid player in the NBA, if moving him gets you back to that point. Now, the last thing that I'll say on Talen Horton-Tucker is the Lakers did THT no favors. And this is, again, part of why I'm still a little bit optimistic about his long-term value. Last season, what did the Lakers do? They went and traded for Russell Westbrook. On paper, if you were to think of anybody in the entire NBA that is a terrible fit next to Talen Horton-Tucker, make a list of the worst fits in the league, Russell Westbrook is probably at the top of it. And then on a minutes basis, THT played about half of his minutes with Russell Westbrook on the floor, sharing the floor with him. The reason why it's such a problem in terms of fit, having Russ and THT together, is because they have similar weaknesses. Teams will not defend him behind the three-point line. So if you have those two guys on the floor together, you have two defenders camped in the paint, and both Russ and THT do their best work when they get into the paint and either finish at the rim or they're kicking out to open shooters. Really hard to do that when the paint is packed. If you're THT and you drive in and Russ's defender is standing there and you look at who you're going to kick out to and nobody cares if you hit Russ behind the three-point line, that is not a good situation to be in. So remember, THT played about half of his minutes on the season, sharing the floor with Russell Westbrook, and that is about the worst combination that you can create in the NBA. So there is some hope that once you get THT into a situation where he's not sharing the floor with Russell Westbrook, he should look a bit better. Now, does that explain all of it? No, not at all. That does not completely excuse his production this season. He certainly was underwhelming, but I also think the environment that he was in was not ideal for his growth or his production. So again, there is some reason to be optimistic that next season THT should look significantly better than he did this season. But again, for the Lakers, the question is, do you trade THT this summer, knowing that you're probably trading him at a low point in terms of value, or do you hang on to him and see if he can drastically improve his performance next season, particularly if Russell Westbrook is indeed on his way out the door? Lakers Nation, give me your thoughts on the Talen Horton-Tucker situation. Number one, should the Lakers trade him this summer? And do you think he can improve moving forward? Or are you completely out on him? Give me your thoughts in the comments down below. And don't forget, subscribe right here to the Lakers Nation YouTube channel. Ring that notification bell as well. Till next time, stay safe and see ya.